You're working as a team of scientists, working together to find out how does volcanic ash clouds impact aviation.
Research shows that from middle school on, girls are much less likely to show an interest in studying STEM subjects than boys. Today, only 23% of STEM-related careers are held by women. So what's holding girls back from an interest in STEM? And what do we do to get more girls interested in STEM careers? To answer this, 4th through 8th grade teachers in Southwest Washington are participating in nPower Girls to learn instructional practices that support female students in STEM. One of the roadblocks students can face is a fear they're not smart enough for STEM studies. nPower Girls embraces the concept of positive growth mindset to counter it.
It's been pretty powerful being a teacher in mathematics when a student messes up. I was like, well, you don't get it, and then yet. So that it just keeps, it gives students the belief that they can move past their mistakes.
And so this is from Mount St. Helens, this is Mount Rainier.
Teachers are visiting the USGS Cascades Volcano Observatory in Vancouver, Washington, to increase teacher content knowledge in STEM disciplines. When you live with the threat of an active volcano in your backyard, STEM study can be more than academic. In fact, studies show that girls are more interested in science when they engage in local phenomena. It's also an opportunity to meet women in STEM careers.
I'm picturing my own students standing up in front of me talking. Because, you know, kids, they see themselves through your eyes. And so if they know their teacher is imagining them in a certain way, then they feel like they can become that as well.
If that volcano erupted, how is that affecting that whole ecosystem?
My first experience is we went on this field trip and did hands-on project-based learning. And I'm like, whoa, I like this. They were like, this is the model that we're looking for, and what do you think? And so I instantly got on fire for it.
Okay, so what's this telling you?
This is the, like, activity and, like, sound.
Oh, the sound.
I love science.
Oh, like, programming. I enjoy that.
Engineering.
I want to be a biochemist.
What makes nPower Girls unique is our focus on using research-based strategies for supporting girls in the classroom. So our teachers select one of these strategies and they conduct their own action research around it. So it could be growth mindset or visual spatial skills. But what's most important is that they're able to directly measure the outcome for students. And this is where we see the most change and the most gains in our students. Kids spend the most time in the classroom with their teachers, so we really want our teachers to be well-versed in making sure that that environment is safe and that all girls can participate in STEM equitably.